smashing on those hearts, because the more you smash and dash, ladies and gentlemen, Unstoppable Idol.
I put my armor on.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we are definitely unstoppable today. We're in season 8. Yes, 8 months ago, ladies and gentlemen, 8 months ago, I would have never imagined that we would one day be here with each and every one of you. Yes, with each and every one of you. All right, so we're going to go ahead and bring in our judges. So you guys already heard from our special guest judge, yes? But there's a couple that you haven't heard from, and we're going to go ahead and bring them in the box right now. Right, or as Mandy would say, right meow. Yas. Ladies and gentlemen, Hashi is in the box.
Hey, everyone. How is everyone? We're excited tonight to have auditions, which I'm so excited. We have amazing contestants. Martin, some updates for you. I have heard from Nick at Night, and he is coming to audition. So he is not pulled out. He's having problems with his phone. So he is joining us to audition. Hey, Mandy, love you. So he is in. We're going to be starting with Unknown Existence tonight because he's got time right now, soon after we do Chris. But a little bit for you guys in the live. So you were wondering how we decide auditions. We do have a panel of judges. And tonight, if you did not catch it, Bailey, who was our winner of season 7, will be our guest judge tonight. We'll be eliminating down to 10 contestants. We do have 12 signed up. We're not sure if all 12 are going to show up, but we will eliminate down to 10 contestants. If we have 10 or less, no eliminations tonight, which is exciting for judges. We get to just watch. But we will be eliminating. We'll be announcing that tomorrow. So don't stick around after the show. You can, but it'll eventually go, it'll end. We're not going to comment this week. We normally comment after each contestant. We will not do that this week because we have three contestants. We'll just talk at the very beginning. We'll talk again at the end. Another note for you guys. This is a reminder for you, Martin. You wanted to mention a young man who died. I'm just putting that reminder in your head. And then there was something else I was going to say. Oh, contestants, when you get in the box, take a big breath, relax, push that screen, and all those comments will disappear. Make sure you're visible in the screen like this. We want to see your whole face and give it all you got. We're rooting for you. We want you to do the best you can. So bring it. Use those nerves and dig in. And we're excited for you, okay? I'm going to pop out and let Chris, if Chris is here, jump in. Bye-bye.
All right. Thank you, Hashi. Is Chris here yet? No, not yet. Okay. That's okay. All right. So let's say hi to a couple of people. The Big Boss Man is here. Yes. He is one of the green badges here on the Meet Me app, ladies and gentlemen. Please make sure you guys go and favorite him. Ask him what the heck is a green badge. We're trying to work towards our million to get a top badge, and he has a green badge. So make sure you guys go and favorite him and ask him, what the heck is a green badge? Yes! Alrighty. Is it Yoey? Yoke? Perch? I am so sorry. I have no idea what your name is. But nevertheless, they are top badge here on the Meet Me app. So please make sure that you go and favorite them. Hi, the idol. You know, my name is Easy and your name is very hard. So we're going to say hello, Half Moon, Strawberry. I think that's a Yoey. Cherries. Top badge, favorite, them. Thank you for that favorite. Much love and appreciation. All right. Oh, the comments are just coming. Alrighty, so with that being said, All right, so do we have Chris yet? No? Are we ready for our first contestant? Yes? Okay. So before we bring out our first contestant, ladies and gentlemen, I would just like to take a moment of silence for one of our Disney actors. He was only 20 years old and he passed away, Mr. Cameron Boyce. It was very sad to hear that news. For those of you, there's a lot that he has played in. And so where I really like grew attached to him is in the sitcom show, Jesse. If you guys ever remember that, hey Jesse. Yes, and so it was very, very sad. So just in case if you guys do not know, he had passed away in his sleep, and he had a seizure. He had some medical issues already, but he had a seizure in his sleep, and no one could get to him, and he passed. So he was only 20 years old. He had a huge, huge future. Very, very talented individual. So if we can just take a moment and, in remembrance of Cameron Boyce, ladies and gentlemen. All right. Thank you guys for doing that. When I heard that news, it was just kind of like, at first I was just like, cause you know, I never knew his real name. You know, usually when you follow an actor, you don't really know their name. You know, their names that they played in the shows that they watched. And so when I first heard it, I was just like, oh, that's sad. And then when I started looking at the pictures and I called Hashi and I was like, do you know this Cameron Boyce guy, person? And so we looked it up together. I was like, oh my God, I cannot believe I didn't know who the hell he was, you know? And so it was me and Hashi both had a moment. And so, very, 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 very sad. So with that being said, we're going to go ahead and bring out our first contestant. Yes? Are you guys ready? If you guys are ready for the first contestant, give me a hell yeah. Okay, so we got two people. Okay, there we go. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, so I forgot you guys were switching it up. And so who is this? Is this, oh, okay, perfect. Ladies and gentlemen, me. It's a whole bunch of question marks on my end. All right, so ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Unknown Existence is in the box. Yes.
Hi.
Hello, Mr. Is it okay? So say your name for us.
My name is John. I'm originally from the Philippines, but I live in Michigan. But right now I'm in Canada for a business trip.
Very nice. Very nice. Okay. So, Mr. John, John, known existent. So, all right, if you can tell us, I know that you have to hurry. So if you just tell us what it is that you're doing, and why do you want to be the next Unstoppable Idol?
To be honest, I'm not aiming to win this competition. I just want to gain experience and maybe boost my confidence a little bit. That's it.
Okay, very nice, very nice. All right, so what is it that you're gonna do for us?
I'm going to sing "Act Like You Love Me" by Shawn Mendes.
Okay, all right. Well, you have the floor. Go ahead.
But I might just I'm shaking. I'm literally shaking right now.
It's okay. Just take a deep breath and start whenever you're ready.
Okay. I'll try. So you leave tomorrow, just leave the night. I promise I'll make things right. I'll make you breakfast the way you like. Before you leave tomorrow, just let me try. Before you leave tomorrow, before you say goodbye. Before you leave tomorrow, before you leave, stay here and lay here right in my arms. It's only a moment before you're gone. And I'm keeping you warm. Just act like you love me so I can go on. Like you love me so I can go on. Just one more night, lying in bed, whether it's wrong or right. Just gotta make sense of it, and you'll be gone in the morning, and you'll be over this. Just one more night, so I can forget. Stay here and lay here right in my arms. It's only a moment before you're gone. And I'm keeping you warm. Just act like you love me so I can go on. When you go, I can't watch you leave. Just promise me you'll sneak out when I'm asleep. And when you go, when you're miles round the world, I wake up, it's just a dream. Just stay here and lay here right in my arms. It's so, I'm shaking. Before you're gone. And I'm keeping you warm. Just act like you love me so I can go on. Just stay here and lay here right in my arms. It's only a moment before you're gone. And I'm keeping you warm. Just act like you love me so I can go on. And act like you love me so I can go on. Just act like you love me. I can do it.
All right. So
I'm sorry. I'm sweating a lot. Jesus Christ.
First and foremost, I want to say that I am proud of you, okay? I am proud of you.
Wait, 1 second.
Because you, when you go in your own lives, you always have a black screen.
I'm sweating.
Very rarely do we ever see you. And you stepped up to the plate today. And even though you couldn't finish, you still did it. And so I am proud of you for that, okay?
It's... it's just a lot of pressure because I need to go back to the business meeting, and then at the same time I'm shaking. I'm literally shaking, nervous. You can see in my sweat.
I understand. So just go ahead and go back to your meeting, and you know, the judges are going to come in a little bit later. Hopefully you can come back and join us for the critiques.
All right, thank you guys.
All right, thank you. Bye-bye. Yes, guys, please make sure you guys go and favorite him. It takes a lot. Trust and believe when I tell you this, ladies and gentlemen. It takes a lot to get up here in women's clothes and in makeup and perform for each and every one of you guys. It takes a lot of confidence. And so when those people get into the box and they're singing their hearts out, whether they can sing or not, it's a lot of confidence for them to, you know, do that. So please, even if you think that they did a wonderful job or they did a horrible job, please just send them that favorite anyways, only because of the confidence that they had to get in that box. Yes? All right. So with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to go with contestant number two. Yes! Ladies and gentlemen, he was one of the contestants of season, I do believe season six-ish? Five, maybe? I don't remember. No, I'm teasing. He was part of season six, ladies and gentlemen. I want you guys to help me welcome him back to the backs. Mr. 515 Dog is in the box. Yes. Hello, Mr. Dar. So, first and foremost, are you sober today?
Yes.
All right.
Surprisingly.
Just need to make sure of that.
Let's not bring that up during week three.
Right.
So we all know what happened.
You're very energetic. And so basically, if you can just, for the live, tell us who you are, what it is that you're doing, and why do you want to become the next Unstoppable Idol?
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Mr. 515 Dar. I'll be singing Let It Go by James Bay. And the reason why I want to be the next Unstoppable Idol is because during season six, I went farther than I thought I would been, but I didn't get that grasp very well. So hopefully I can go all the way and hopefully win it. I have the confidence, I have the heart, and I hope you guys enjoy. It is Mountain Dew, right, by the way.
Oh.
It's nothing. Wait, nothing.
This broadcast, this performance is brought to you by Mountain Dew. Do the Dew.
Mountain Dew.
Yeah. All right. From walking home and talking thoughts, to singing shows and evening clothes with you, from nervous touch and getting drunk, to staying up and waking up with you. Now we're sleeping at the edge and holding something we don't need. All this illusion in our heads is gonna bring us to our knees. So come on, let it go. Just let it be. Why don't you be you? And I'll be me. Everything that's broke, leave it to the breeze. Why don't you be you? And I'll be me. And I'll be me. From throwing clothes across the floor to teeth and claws and slamming doors to you. If this is all we're living for, what are we doing it anymore? I used to recognize myself as funny how selections change. When we're becoming something else, I think it's time to walk away. So come on, let it go. Just let it be. Why don't you be you? And I'll be me. Everything that's broke, leave it to the breeze. Why don't you be you? And I'll be me. And I'll be me. Trying to fit your hand inside of mine when we don't know just don't belong. There's no force on earth that would make me feel right. No, whoa. Trying to push this problem up the hill when it's just too heavy to hold. Thinking how's the time to let this slide? So come on, let it go. Just let it be. Why don't you be you? And I'll be me. Everything that's broke, leave it to the breeze. Let the ashes fall. Forget about me. Come on, let it go. Just let it be. While you be you, and I'll be me. And I'll be me. Oh my God, I'm shaking.
I know, it's nervousing once you get in that box. You guys should see how I feel. I never show it, but trust and believe me, you guys. Yes.
The National Service announcement has just issued a thunderstorm warning for the Idols Live.
Oh, well, at least it's not an earthquake. Oh, too soon? Too soon? Cut it out.
Exactly.
My bad. This is on our way there, so you know, just saying. We might get sunk in a hole or something. I don't know. But how do you feel about your performance right now?
Anxious, really nervous, and I think I did pretty good.
Very nice, very nice. I love that confidence. All right. Okay, so just go ahead and sit in the live. The judges are going to come in at the very end and kind of give critiques in a whole. and we'll just go from there, okay?
Okay.
All right, thanks. Oh, sweet Jesus. Booth Lord, I could have went all night without you saying that. Okay. All right. All righty. Contestant number three. Can you get in the box, please? Your answer, please. That was like a talk show. Your answer, please. Okay, we're done with that. Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, so it's contestant number three is Mr. Reg NYC is in the box. Yes.
Now, hi. Hey, Idol.
Hello, Reg. How are you?
You don't know what I went through just to get ready. For some reason... Oh. I should have been there, but for some reason it took me a very long time, but I just got here in time. I am ready to go.
And I'm very anxious, Rake, because you know, you're also a returning contestant from the Idol show of season 6. And I remember right after, it was like a week after, you're like, Idol, I am coming back for season 9 or season 8, and you know, I'm gonna work extra hard. So I'm very, very anxious to see your performance today, just like the judges are and the viewers in the live. So if you just go ahead and tell us exactly who you are, what it is that you're doing for us today, and why do you want to become the next Unstoppable Idol?
Okay, my name is Reg, aka UNYC, Unique New York City. I'm a music producer, rap artist, singer, dancer, and a filmmaker. Why do I want to be the next Unstoppable Idol? Well, not only for my, you know, own reasons, you know, for promotion and marketing my brand, but I also want to inspire others to reach for the stars and be the best person they can be, whether it's music or whatever skill or talent that they have. Just, you know, always trust, believe in yourself, prayers, and give it everything you got. Let the chips fall where they may. Hey, Spidey, and please favor me. Please favor me, check out my live stream. I do it all the time. All the time.
Right.
On my music.
Okay. Very nice, very nice. He actually talks how he types in messages. It's like there's still a little bit more. Oh, a little bit more. Oh, a little bit more. No, but I love it. That's what I love about you, Reg. I love about you. You have the floor. Make sure you turn off the comments. You have the floor, and take a deep breath. And you got the floor.
Oh, the song I'm doing is Doing My Best. The song that I did last season, but had audio problems. I got it fixed now, so let's do a quick sound check, make sure that you can hear me and everything. I don't want to make sure that, you know, everything is fine, so we don't have that problem again. Okay.
Right.
Mic check. 1 2 1 2 1 2. Do you hear the music? Do you hear me? Perfect. Clear? All right, great. We're ready. All right, one more thing. Mom, go ahead, go into live. Okay, my mom's watching.
Oh. All right, here
we go. Yeah, she's watching me.
Very nice.
Say hi.
Nice. So now you know you gotta come. You gotta bring it now. Mom is in the live. She is watching you. So you have to bring it.
Here we go. Here we go. Ooh, yeah. gotta strive to survive. A sweet thing named Olivia, prettier than your average chick. Face of a model and fix in front of camera, natural beauty, but inside just rotted out. Lost a father, ate for him, and frankly shot it out over petty shit. Lost it to a crack fiend mother, last dick sucker, toe up, backseat lover. She bringing tricks back to the crib. Olivia stuck in the room. Through the wall, she hear her mom getting fucked. She wanna break away, packing her bags up. What little she had, she's 16 and now she's hitting the app. No other option but to sell herself. A sad thing, so much potential, now she killing her health. Mr. Period, shit is serious. Who is the father? But fuck it, if she knew the dude, probably couldn't be bothered. She closed her eyes and she think of her pops. Pray to God, now she doing this. That's the move, self of the block. Yo. Coming up in this cold world, nobody gives a damn. Gotta try to survive, oh yeah. Staying on your grind, pray to God, people should be blessed. When you're doing your best. Now she preparing to be a parent and stacking ends. No longer fucking with them broke back block bitches or crab friends. She got a GED diploma. Called word to her mom's old money and got beat to a coma. Heartbroken and falling to pieces. Nowhere to turn, so she talks to Jesus. Heart so cold that it freezes. Yo, but stays focused, can't afford to be hopeless. I tried to survive, can't afford to be homeless. And when her baby dropped, she felt joy. Tears of passion ran down her cheek when she seen a boy. She getting help from welfare, supplying her funds to put her son up in daycare. Now she grinding. Upgraded, taking courses at community college. When you hustle, opportunity follows. Here's a round of applause, cause she passed the test. Olivia rose up from nothing, that's from doing your best. Coming up in this cold world, nobody gives a damn. Gotta strive to survive. Whoa, staying on your grind. Pray to God, he will surely bless. When you're doing your best, she's doing real good. Food in the fridge and it feels good. Finally made it after taking all that she could. Got a good job in RN, paying the rent. Nice car in the crib for years. She was staying in the trench, but it's all in the past. At last, the future is bright. A lifetime of darkness, she finally moved to the light. A new beginning, just a sun in herself. She put it all on the shelf. A wise woman, rich in knowledge as well. A survivor since shorty was a child, young, innocent, with the most gorgeous of smiles, that she done grown into a fine young woman, and she deserved a standing ovation for making it off of the curb. Yeah, so fuck a stereotype and a statistic. It says she wasn't meant to make it, but she must have missed it. And if you're like Olivia, born with less skies and limit, you can get it all by doing your best. Coming up in this cold world, nobody gives a damn. Gotta try to survive, oh yeah. Staying on your grind, pray to God, he will surely bless. When you're doing your best, yeah. Oh, yeah. You gotta try to survive. Pray to God, he will surely bless you. Just keep doing your best.
Yes.
Done.
Very, very nice. I actually enjoyed this. With you singing and doing a little rapping at the same at the same time is what I was trying to get at. But yeah, so how do you feel about your performance?
Beginning, good. My singing was okay, but I think it improved. It got better because I had a little bit of nerves going on, but it improved as I moved into the song, as I got comfortable. I think I did well.
All right. Awesome. All right. Well, just go ahead and sit in the live, and we'll wait for the judges' critiques at the end.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Idol. Favorite me.
All righty. So we've been through three contestants so far, ladies and gentlemen. And so we're off to a good start. So with that being said, are we ready for contestant number four? Yes. We ready for contestant number four? We was about to have a cleanup on aisle two. All right. Hello, Carmen. Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? Yes, I love your outfit. Oh, thank you, Carmen. I appreciate that so much. You know, every time, you know, Carmen comes in here, ladies and gentlemen, it's such a privilege. And when she compliments anything of mine, it's such a humbling feeling, because it's just kind of like, because, you know, she's a makeup artist. She even makes her own makeup. So she has a very new show here on the Meet Me app every Thursday, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And she's lit. She's lit. You know, when trolls come in, I love how she deals with them. She treats them with kindness. It kind of reminds me of me, of how I do it as well. And so, you know, it's awesome. It was, I think, someone came in, I hope you don't mind this, Carmen, but someone came in and was like, makeup is boring. And she's like, makeup is boring? I'm sorry. So anyways, this is what you do. And I mean, and she just kept going. Like, it did not affect her at all, you know. And so, she was just like, I'm sorry. You know, so she's also a top badge here on the Meet Me app. So please make sure that you guys send her a favorite. And check out our shows every Thursday. You know, I know we've been drilling it in your head, you know, Meet Me Talent Thursdays, you know, at 3 p.m. So you just got five more hours, and then you get the fabulous talents of Miss Where in the World is Carmen Sandiego every Thursday night, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Put it on your calendar, people. Put it on your calendars. All righty. So have we seen Cosmic? No? All right, contestant number five, are you ready? Yes. All right, contestant number five, if you're ready, viewers, if you're ready, judges, if you're ready, please request the box. And then, ladies and gentlemen, after this contestant, we're going to bring in our special guest. I know I have not mentioned anything about this special guest because I kind of wanted it to be a huge surprise. If you have me on Instagram, you know exactly who our special guest is. And it is so amazing that he is here. You know, he still got his senses. So if a crime happens, he's probably got a jet, and so we're gonna definitely try to get him in the box before any type of crime happens and he has to rush off, you know, because, you know, blink of the eye, you know, blink of the eye, he's gone. So, you know, I'm just saying right after this next contestant, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Christian is in the box. Yes.
Back up a little bit, I guess. Camera's a little bit closer than I thought. Yes, how are you?
Well, I'm better now. How are you? That's the question.
Doing fantastic.
You know, I don't know if it's just me, you guys, but I think I just fell in love. I mean, he's so handsome looking, and you know, he's a ginger. No, this is too much. Too much.
Okay. No, you're fine.
No, I'm teasing. I'm teasing you guys. Christian is a very No, no, I'm not. He is handsome. Okay, so anyways, tell us who you are, what it is that you're going to do for us, and why would you like to be the next Unstoppable Idol?
All right. Well, as was already said, my name is Christian. A lot of the people in my lives.
He wins, ladies and gentlemen. I'm teasing. What's that? I was like, he wins. No, I'm teasing. Go ahead.
As was already said, my name is Christian. People in my lives know me as HT or Hidden Talents. And some of my closer people might call me Baby Bro, as Turk does, or Z, as some of my longer friends know me for. the song that I'm going to be doing is Love Like You by Rebecca Sugar. It comes from the Steven Universe series. And I would like to be the next Unstoppable Idol because, for one, I want to be able to show people what I can do, what I'm capable of. And as was said, with the first contestant, I think it would help as a confidence boost because I do have times where I let anxiety get to me. And right now, I'm actually pretty relaxed. I just would like to show people that, you know, I could do it.
All right. Very nice. Very nice. Okay, well, you have the floor. So show us that you can do it. Be like Nike.
One more. All right. Begin to be half of what you think of me. I could do about anything. I could even learn how to love. When I see the way you act, wondering when I'm coming back. I could do about anything. I could even learn how to love like you. I always thought I might be bad. Now I'm sure that it's true. I think you're so good, and I'm nothing like you. Look at you go, I just adore you. I wish that I knew what makes you think I'm so special. If I could begin to do something that does right by you, I would do about anything. I would even learn how to love. When I see the way you look, shaking my how long it took. I could do about anything. I could even learn how to love like you. Love like you. I always thought I might be bad. Now I'm sure that's true. 'Cause I think you're so good, and I'm nothing like you. Look at you go, I just adore you. I wish that I knew what makes you think I'm so special. If I could have stayed to be everything you've thought of me, could have done about anything, but I think I've learned how to love like you.
Very, very nice.
Thank you. Thank you.
You know, I don't know if I should go to the next contestant, stop the show, drive to where you're at. I mean, I don't know. I'm just saying. No, but how do you feel about your performance?
I don't know. I don't want to sound too humble, like I'm trying to milk it or anything, but I don't want to sound like I'm the most confident person in the world. I feel like confidence could have used maybe a dash bit more work, but I think I hit all the points that I meant to hit.
Very nice. Very nice. All right. Well, you did a good job. Just go ahead and wait in the live, and at the end, the judges are going to come in with critique. So.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Thank you, Christian. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 5. Oh, he's like holding up like the real American Idol. Vote for me, 5. Yeah. Contestant number 5, Mr. Christian. Yes.
Thank you.
So if you want to vote for him, 1-800-IDOL-5. Correct. All righty. I'm not quite ready for our special guest as of yet. So we're gonna go ahead and bring out contestant number 6. Sorry, special guest. All right, contestant number 6, are you ready? You have to be, 1-800-HUNTY-IDOL, ready to hunt for Ginger. Oh, that is correct. Correction. Look, I am your father. Bully, thank you for that favorite. Much love and appreciation. You know, I think I saw Angie come in here, ladies and gentlemen. She is one of the top badges here. Excuse me, on the Meet Me app. So please make sure that you guys go and favorite her. Also, Nicole is in the house or in the live. You know, I think we should get Nicole as a special guest for the Idol show. Yes, I think we should. We should get to know Miss Nicole. I don't know. I mean, I'm just saying. All righty. Please make sure that you guys go and favorite Angie and also Nicole. Their lives is pretty lit. Yes, pretty lit. So please make sure you guys go and favorite them. Contestant number 6, are you ready? She is ready. She is. Ladies and gentlemen, she is a ducking. She is a Viking. Nevertheless, she is definitely a queen. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Viking Queen is in the box. Yes!
You're on.
Well, hello.
Hello, Miss Viking Queen. How are you?
Good. How are you today?
Good. Thanks for asking.
Good. Thanks for asking.
I love this outfit. Gracious. I love this outfit. So,
thank you. I ducking love this outfit myself. It's so ducking awesome.
It is ducking awesome. I know, it's only when I talk, Nicole, so I'm gonna do it really quickly. All right, so a couple of weeks ago, you know, we saw this beautiful dress that you had on because you were at a wedding, yes?
Yeah, my brother-in-law's, yeah.
Yes. So, and I'm just saying, I love it. I love the like, you know, the diversity in outfits, yes? All right, so tell us who you are, what it is that you're doing for us. Tell us who you are, what it is that you're doing for us, and why do you want to become the next Unstoppable Idol? Yes.
Well, my name is Tammy, also known as the Ducking Viking Queen. I am going to be singing Carrie Underwood's Before He Cheats. It really gets me because, like, I've been cheated on a lot through my life, so there's a lot of emotion in that. And I want to be the next Unstoppable Idol because I've always been part of music in my life, like ever since I was young in school. And like I've always been like pushed to try, like by my husband who passed away, by my friends on the app, my friends in real life. It's just me, music.
All right, very nice, very nice. All right, well, you have the floor. Go right ahead.
All right, Izzy started at 1 second. Absolutely love that song. You know, when Carrie Underwood came out with that song, I was just like, girl, she been through some shit, some stuff. And so I absolutely love that song. I absolutely love that song. And so how do you feel about that performance? I feel pretty good. I don't even think I messed up.
You know, at the very beginning, we couldn't hear you, and so I kept doing this at you.
Yeah, but my moved the speaker away a little bit. I didn't know it was too close.
No, that's okay. But then we heard you closer to the end. So, all right. So just go ahead and wait until the live for the judges' critiques. Yes.
Well, thank you, everyone. Love y'all.
All right. Thank you. All right, so I think I saw Chris come in. Yes? Chris, would you like to jump in the box and introduce yourself real quick? Yes. Oh, okay. Okay. Gotcha. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead with our special guest. Yes? Are you guys ready for the special guest? Yes? Alrighty. Ladies and gentlemen, he is here, all the way from New York City. You know, it was very hard to capture him to get this moment in the box. Ladies and gentlemen, Spider-Man is in the box! Yes!
Oh, what's up, everybody? How's it going?
Hello, Spider-Man. How are you? I'm sorry, this spectacular Spidey. How are you?
Oh, man. It was just crazy, though. I was literally just at CVS just a second ago, and then when I heard I was on, so I had to swing back over here. But it was crazy, though. There was a lot of shooting going on. And then all the policemen that came afterwards, they're like, so you're going to be the next Iron Man one? I was like, I don't have time for that. I'm too busy doing you guys' jobs.
Very Nice, very nice.
Like, because I'm getting ready to go on vacation. If you guys want to find out that vacation, make sure you check out Spider-Man Far From Home, which is in theaters right now. So please go check that out. But everybody, I wanted to congratulate Mr. Idol here on all of his accomplishments. He is one of my inspirations, just to let you guys know. Oh, now it's, I'm glad you enjoyed it. How's it going, guys? How's it going, guys? I hope you guys are having the best time possible. Remember, guys, we all got to be spectacular in here, because this is one of the best live streams going on Meet Me, though. So make sure you do tune in with that.
Very, very nice. Well, you know, Spidey, I know you're a busy guy. I know you're a busy, busy spider, actually. But you have a few moments.
Oh, of course, I make time.
Okay. So we're gonna have some crowd participation. All right, so Spidey is gonna answer any question that you may have for him. Yes, so please, if you have any questions for this spectacular Spider-Man, please, right now, ask your questions. All right, so the first question for you, someone wants to know, how long is your web?
Oh, Bella, this is one thing you gotta know. Tom Holland, Tobey Maguire, and Andrew Garfield, those are my actors. They're trying to do their best impersonation of me, though, but they're doing a real good job with that. But no one actually really knows what the real Peter Parker looks like, just to let you know. I always try to keep that secure, so that way you guys don't be in trouble, so that way you guys stay safe, y'all guys are able to sleep at night.
Gotcha. Thank you very much. All right, so do we have any other questions while we have Spider-Man in the box? Okay, so that's not an appropriate question. All right, do we have any other questions for Spidey?
What did I think of Deadpool? Oh, Deadpool. I only saw him actually one time, though, and that was through my very first few weeks when I first met Nick Fury, when he was showing me, like, the new high tech. And, you know?
Very nice.
You know, when he says he's actually not a superhero, well, you got that right, though. But other than that, though, he tries to do good for the world, though. We just need to tighten him up a little bit, so that way we can make him a real X-Men. Because right now, I've been told that I'm supposed to call him X-Men trainee, just to let you know.
Someone had asked, do you have a girlfriend?
Oh, do I have a girlfriend? Let me check my phone. Yeah, it's MJ, though. I actually just finally got the chance to tell her how I feel on the trip. And you guys can find out that trip when you check out Far From Home, which was a bit chaotic. But it was fun. But I got it done. And me and MJ are doing fine. We're doing great, which is a great accomplishment.
Very nice. Okay, this is one last question for me. How was it when you kissed MJ upside down?
Oh, I just went with the flow, though. I just went with the flow, and it just happened. That's how certain things go. You just gotta go with the flow. But it was kind of awkward, though, but it was cool. I gave that the thumbs up.
Very nice. Well, you know, Spectacular Spidey, I want to thank you for taking out the time of your busy schedule to be here on the Unstoppable Idol Show. You are super, super amazing. I can't wait to see your movie on July 19th. I'm looking forward to it. I'm looking forward forward to you definitely coming back. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be awesome.
Yeah, it was an honor. It was an honor to be on your show, though, because I don't get invited to too much parties with one because I'm not over 21 yet. Just to let you guys know. But you guys are awesome, and Idol, you keep doing what you're doing, keep being spectacular, and just try not to get in trouble because we don't want to run into each other. But other than that, you keep being good.
All right, thank you guys. All right, so we'll see you later, Spidey. Yes. Alrighty. Yes, you know, I'm very excited that Spider-Man took time out of his busy schedule to be on the Idol show. Yes, it's amazing. It's amazing. So we won't tell Spidey how I robbed that bank last week. Yes? No, I bet.
How we robbed the bank.
Right, how we. We won't tell him. You didn't catch everybody. Okay, so anyways, moving along. I'm just joking. Meet me, don't ban me. All right, so our next contestant, ladies and gentlemen. You know, this show, let me tell ya. Alrighty, so this next contestant, and then I got an announcement to make for next week's show. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a little huge. Not big huge, but it's just a little huge. So make sure you guys stay tuned for an announcement for next week's show. Yes! All right. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 7, Mr. Mojo is in the box. I don't know, maybe he needed to get his mojo back. I don't know. Oh! What do you want from me? All right, so while he's trying to get his music, his sound to cooperate, did you guys see Adam Lambert on Good Morning America? Yes?
Yes.
It's like in... Yes, so, I mean, it was a very good song. He had done some of his newer songs, and then he did one of his older songs, which I love. What is it? What do you do to me? Hey, hey. Yeah, I love that song. I absolutely love that song. He's brilliant, yes. And so just in case if you guys don't know who Adam Lambert is, he won... He won Unstoppable Idol season back in 2009. No, he won runner-up. No, he didn't win. I'm so sorry. He was the first runner-up. Chris Allen won that season 8 of American Idol, and he was the runner-up. And so, but let me tell you, he had this purple outfit on. You know, I would have swore him down. It was Prince for a split second, you know, with the shoes and everything. If you guys didn't see it, Google it because it's on YouTube. He was doing a song for Good Morning America. It was fabulous. All right, so we're going to bring him back in the box, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Mojo. Yas.
Can you guys hear me now?
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Hello, Unstoppable Idol. I am Mojo. My real name is Muhammad. Danny and Trucker, thank you for the support. Appreciate that. How's everyone doing tonight?
We're doing fabulous. We're doing fabulous.
Good. Okay, good so to hear. Good to hear.
Okay, so
there is going to be a slight echo, yeah. Slight. I dressed up for this evening. Yeah.
All right. I'm going to see if I can fix this. Really quick.
I appreciate that.
All right. So did we do better?
Is there any echo?
I don't know if there's still.
A bit. Still echo?
Okay, there's still an echo. All right. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and do my little spill, and then you can go ahead and go.
Okay, no problem.
All right, so basically just tell us who you are, again, what it is that you're doing for us, and why you want to become the next Unstoppable Idol.
Okay, I go by Mojo. I have like 800 followers. I just started about, 2 months ago. How do I want to get? Well, I'm going to do A Million Reasons by Lady Gaga. I want to start off, kind of slow and, kind of progress. If I progress, I'll do more of what I usually do. And I kind of want to do a show. So I want to do like a request hour of music. So, people could join my live and then request whatever comes to their minds if you want to test me out or something like that. Just to get some more followers and, play for you guys. And that's about it.
Very nice. All right. Well, you have the floor. Go right ahead.
You're giving me a million reasons to let you go. You're giving me a million reasons to get the show. You're giving me a million reasons. Give me a million reasons. Giving me a million reasons. About a million reasons. If I had a highway, I would head for the hills. You can find a driveway, I'll forever be still. Cause you're giving me a million reasons. Give me a million reasons. Giving me a million reasons. About a million reasons. To pray, try to make the worst seem better. Lord, show me the way to cut through all this worn-out leather. I've got 100 million reasons to walk away, but baby, I just need one good one to stay. It's like in a cycle, I look up and stare. It's like I stop breathing, but completely aware. Cause you're giving me a million reasons. Give me a million reasons. Giving me a million reasons. About a million reasons. If you had to say something, you might even mean. It's how they even fathom which ones I should believe. Cause you're giving me a million reasons. Give me a million reasons. Giving me a million reasons. About a million reasons. I'm out to pray, try to make the worst seem better. Lord, show me the way to cut through all this worn-out leather. I got 100 million reasons to walk away, but baby, I just need one good one to stay. Can you give me what I'm needing, needing? Every heartbreak makes it hard to keep the faith. But baby, I just need one good one, good one, good one, good one, good one. When I'm bowed down to pray, try to make the words seem better. Lord, show me the way. We got the wall is worn and leather. I've got 100 million reasons to walk away. just need one, good one. Tell me that you'll be the good one, baby. I just need one good one to stay. Thank you so much, guys. Appreciate it.
Wow. You know, I must ask. Thank you for that fire.
Yes,
he deserves that. So I just want to know, what gives you your inspiration?
My mom. Well, my mom, she was when I was younger. She was my inspiration. She passed away when I was 15 through a car accident. But she was a soprano. She sang in Juilliard. And, you know, when I was younger, she always used to pull me aside and be like, you know, you got a good voice, Mo. You know, you should practice with me sometime. And so when she was, like, cooking in the kitchen, I remember, like, distinctly, like, her, like, you know, teaching me, you know, how to cook and sing at the same time. So, you know, she's my inspiration. I mean, with every show that I do, everything that I do, like, that's pretty much my inspiration, you know. Mom!
Well, I'm going to let you know, I'm sure that your mom is proud of what you just presented us today, because you did it. That was amazing.
Thank you.
Amazing. Those
Thank
notes,
you.
Oh. You know, I'm going to say it. So far in this competition, you are the best that we have right now. Yes.
All right, I appreciate it. Thank you.
I mean, I have to say
thank you so much.
I mean, I do, and I'm sure there's a lot of other people that agree with me. So how do you feel about this performance?
I was a little shaky. I mean, I'm kind of like nervous because I don't know, for some reason with competitions, I get really nervous. But like when I'm playing like shows, I don't really get so nervous at all. But, you know, I'm like dry voice and I'm trying to get myself together and stuff like that, you know. But, you know, if you give me a shot, I'll do other songs, and I have like some costume ideas and things like that I want to like get into, you know, go to different styles of music, things like that.
Very nice. All right. Well, thank you so much for being a part of Idol.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Yes. Wow. It's heating up, you guys. The show is heating up. All righty. Are we ready for the next contestant? Yes. Perhaps. Mm-hmm. All righty. We're going to give the judges a few more minutes to finish writing. I think I might be going a little too fast for them. I always wait for Hashi to send me the eyes. That lets me know we're ready to go. There we go. All righty. Maybe. Okay. All right. Our next contestant, ladies and gentlemen. Hold on, is this? Oh, okay. Yes, she is definitely missing in action. Char, Dr. Quinn, medicine woman. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Mia is in the box. Yes.
Oh, hi.
Hello, honey. How are you?
I'm visibly shaking.
Like, yes, this is auditions is very
right. Auditions
is very nerve-wracking.
Hi, Carly. Hi, Karen.
Okay. So you know, tell us a little bit about yourself.
What is it
that you're doing and why you want to become Unstoppable Idol?
I am 22, originally from Virginia. Unfortunately, I now live in Vegas. I hate it. I don't like being hot.
I'm on my way there, girl. I'll be there tomorrow.
Look about that bank you robbed. So, like, if you want to, like, run me some coins, you know, I can be at McCarran Airport. I work right down the street. I actually had a little bit of trouble choosing a song, so I'm going to let you pick a number between 1 and 6.
Oh, I get to pick. Okay. Pick a number six. You know, since my season 7 winner was the contestant number 1 and she won, I'm going to pick 1.
You would pick the hardest one. Okay. We're going to do it. So I'll be doing Vaseline. It's a song by Brandon and Leah. I perform this a lot. I don't know if you know Charismatic. She's actually the one who told me to come in here. So this is actually it's the first song I ever sang for her. So, and it's one of the hardest songs for me to sing. I usually do it when I'm drunk. So that should tell you something. and I want to be the next Unstoppable Idol because this is sort of like my redemption. When I was 18, I auditioned for The Voice and I made it right before the live shows and I ended up getting really sick and couldn't go on. So this is kind of like a redemption for me of sorts. So yeah, I'm excited. All right, let me turn
off. You've got the floor.
Thank you. Okay. Oh, got the...
Nobody knows the trouble I've seen. Nobody knows but me. Wherever I go, it's harder to be. Nobody knows but me. Shooting the shit, thinking you're rich, I'm in the big, throwing a fit. Everybody wants and only I. Does anybody care about anything, anyhow? Everybody's acting like zombie. I got a rock in my pocket, gonna break this glass. Gotta cut myself loose from the upper class, cause it's a sandwich on life with a box of booze and everything. My mama and my daddy give me apprehension, and I find that in my body there's just so much tension. I can get myself together so that things go smooth like Vaseline, Vaseline. Yeah. Nobody knows what love means to me. Nobody knows but me. Wherever I go, I'm built at ease. Nobody knows but me. Faking a smile, living now, ready to die, always on trial. Everybody's lost and lonely. Does anybody care about anything, anyhow? Everybody's acting like a zombie. I got a rock in my pocket, gonna break this glass, gonna cut myself loose from the upper class, cause it's a sandwich on life with a box of booze for every day. My mama and my daddy give me apprehension, and I find that in my body there's just so much tension. I can get myself together so that things go smooth like Vaseline, Vaseline. Yeah. Everybody's lost and lonely. I got a rock in my pocket, gonna break this glass. Gotta cut myself loose from the upper class, cause it's a silly talk. I have a box of booze for every day. My mama
in my daddy, give me apprehension and I find that in my body there's so much tension. I can get myself together so that things go smooth like that's I gotta get myself together so that things go smooth like that's I gotta get myself together so that things are smooth like Vaseline.
Okay.
Very, very nice. I think the last performance I spoke a little too soon, and I'm just gonna leave it at that.
I'm so shaky.
But that voice. pardon me for being selfish, but I'm glad that you did not, that you got sick and you didn't make another voice, because we would have had you on the Unstoppable Idol show. But then again, I can't imagine, and I'm like, if you had made it, where would you be right now? Like, seriously.
Probably flirting with Adam Levine, to be honest. that's my whole... It was so funny because my mom was like, if you make it, you can't pick Adam. And I'm like, why? She's like, you're not going to get anywhere because you're just going to be like this in Adam's face. I'm like, I mean, you're not wrong, but hear me out. I felt so betrayed when he got married. I was so upset.
All right. So how do you feel about this performance?
I started off really shaky, and I know for a fact that I have done this song better. Usually my growls and my runs are a little bit cleaner, but other than that, I think I did okay. I think I just needed a little bit more, what is it? Apple crumb, and then I would have been all right.
Very nice. Yeah. Very nice. Well, if you definitely make sure you work with Hashi. He can help you with that. He can definitely help you with that. And so you did a great job. Great job. Yeah. All right. We're sitting alive, and judges will be back in a little bit. Yes. Wow. It's just like, it's starting to heat up. I think we're on fire already. We're on fire. All right. So before we bring in the next contestant, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to take a moment and kind of make a little bit of announcement about what's happening next week. Yes? All right. So myself and Chris, we will be at VidCon next week, and probably next Sunday, we might be at Disneyland. And so I was thinking, I was just like, you know, with all of the noise and everything, and so of course I had to ask my bosses and all that good stuff, and so they are okay with this. And so we are not, ladies and gentlemen, going to have a show next week. However, you know, I am always live breaking and investigating. So I got with Hashi, and so we did brainstorming. We're always brainstorming. And so what we're going to do is, please make sure that you guys favorite Hashi. Everyone in the live right now, go and favorite Hashi. Yes, he just put all the eyes. If you have not favorited Hashi, please make sure you guys go and favorite him, because what we're going to do for the first time ever on Unstoppable Idol, we are going to do a behind-the-scene show with Hashi. Yes, I'm very, very excited about this, ladies and gentlemen. So next week, I'm going to probably be streaming. I'm still going to be streaming, you know, Walt Disney, and, you know, I'm going to be like, hello, I'm here in Walt Disney with the pipe air, you know, famous as air. She always has the pipe air coming through her house from Disney. So, but I'm going to be there live breaking and investigating. And so all of the contestants will be in Hashi's live. And so, and he's going to be coaching them, critiquing them, getting them ready for week three. And you guys get to see the things that you don't get to see here on Idol, you know? So you guys are gonna see the contestants sweat. You know, I'm gonna be popping in the box and kind of, you know, letting you guys know like how I get them ready for, you know, with a pep talk, you know, in a group chat. All the contestants and myself and the judges, we're all in a group chat. Yes? And so you guys will get to see all of that kind of like behind the scenes, if you will. But we call it behind the curtains of Unstoppable Idol. So make sure you guys tune into that. It's going to be awesome. You know, hopefully, we will get Chris to jump in Hashi's box and kind of, you know, so he can kind of share but we don't know what his physical abilities, where they will be at. So just saying. So with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, as in drunk? Correct. So, but I think it would be hilarious if he was like super, super, yeah, what he said. And he gets in the box and he tries to do it. So, okay, my guys. It would be so tasteful. It would be so tasteful. I would love it. I'm looking forward to it. So make sure you guys go and favorite Hashi, because next Sunday, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to be doing a behind the scenes of the Unstoppable Idol. So please make sure you guys go and favorite him. Yes. All right. So, you know, each and every season, it seems like we're just getting better. We're coming up with amazing news, you know, announcements. You know, starting today, ladies and gentlemen, we're being promoted every single Sunday. Yes, we're being promoted every single Sunday. That's why the numbers are skyrocketing, you know, because, I mean, we're going to be promoted every single Sunday. So, again, I will be streaming next Sunday, but I will be streaming VidCon and Walt Disney Land and all those good stuff. You know, we get to meet some cool people. We get to meet, you know, people from Meet Me. We get to, you know, meet like the higher ups. We get to meet Holly. Yes. Yes, I'm looking forward to meeting Holly. We get to meet Bailey. I get to meet Chris for the very first time. You know, it's going to be like, when I get ready to meet Chris, it's not going to be like very exciting. It's going to be like, oh, what's up, bro? You know, what a fool. Because, I mean, it's kind of like we know each other, you know? We know each other already. So it's just going to be like, oh, what up, dog? What up, dog? Actually, it'll probably be Chris. Oh, what up, my guy? What up, my guy? You know? Exactly, Sammy. We were on the same wavelength. What up, my guy? All right, so he's going to do the Chris clap. He's going to be like, the idol. All right, before we bring in contestant number 9, ladies and gentlemen, please make sure you guys go and favorite Sammy. She is one of the top badges here on the Meet Me app. Yes, she is definitely someone that I have always in my whole like streaming career. Always someone that I looked up to as a top-notch streamer. So please make sure that you guys go and favorite her, because I have learned a lot from her, and I'm sure if you guys go and follow her and just kind of sit back in her lurk and jerk section, and just kind of watch, because she is like super amazing. Okay, all right, so please make sure you guys go and favorite Sammy. Yes. All right, so are we ready for contestant number 9? Contestant number 9, are you ready? Viewers, are you ready? Judges, are you ready? Let's get ready to rumble! Oh, okay, I'm sorry, I thought I was in a wrestling match. Sorry. Sorry, my bad, y'all, my bad. Thought I was in the wrestling match. wrong show, my bad. That's my show on Monday nights. Oh, that was a little butch. Oh, that was too butch, actually. Guys, let's do it. All right. As soon as they request the box, we will do this. Hashi, have you seen this contestant? As of yet. Okay, well. All right, well, while we're waiting, because we've never done this in the Idol, for Unstoppable Idol, so we're gonna do this. While we're waiting for that contestant, we're gonna do this something really quick. We still got 45 minutes anyways. So we're gonna do this. Oh, they went away. Maybe they'll come back. Oops, something has went wrong. Please try again. Okay, so I'm not gonna do that again, just in case if it does like, well, I was gonna battle someone while we wait, but that didn't work. Thank you guys for the amazing gifts. Please make sure that you guys favorite all of my gifters, especially the first three. Super amazing. Please make sure that you guys favorite all of the contestants that you've seen so far. Because remember, this is auditions. It takes a lot of cojones. Doesn't matter if you're a guy or girl. It takes a lot of cojones to get in that box and to perform for 1,570 viewers. Yes? So please make sure you give them all a favorite, even if you think they did horribly, if you think they did, you know, magnificent. Please make sure that you at least send them a favorite. You know, maybe there's something that you see that they could do better in, that you can maybe help them with, you know, as a viewer. You know, that is awesome. You know, if you could reach out, send them a favorite, reach out and say, hey, you know, I saw you on the Idol show, and so I noticed that you were a little pitchy, and so what I did, I don't have the cojones to get on that Idol show, but, you know, I sing a little bit, and so I used to be pitchy, and so, you know, I've been watching Hashi, and so this is what usually Hashi would say, or, you know, this is what you should do, because you could possibly help someone. So please make sure you guys go and favorite all of the contestants. Yes. Alrighty. Let's see. All right, so they're still not there. Okay, so who was it again, Hashi? Got poop mark around mouth, sir. Yes. It's from you, JD. Maybe next time don't sit on my face. All right. Alrighty, so is contestant number 10, is Omega in the live? Oh, just make sure you wash it this time, JD. Alright, so... Alrighty, so I think, is that all the contestants? You know what, Hashi? Omega might be having issues, if you remember in chat earlier. Is there any way you can go into chat and try to reach out to him? Yes. All right, so is Hannah in the live? I know, but I think I forgot to favorite him. That's why I was asking you to reach out to him. Alrighty. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know what contestant number we're on, but this is the next contestant. Miss Hannah is in the box. Or not. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much, one team. Alrighty, we're gonna try her again. Mama Lisa, how are you? Ladies and gentlemen, Hannah is in the box. Maybe we say the bags, she'll appear. Oh, not working. All right, Chris, try to request the box. You know, actually, we've been lonely without Chris. We actually need my guy in the box. You know, I mean, he hasn't been here all show. And so, you know, I just wish he would grace us with his presence. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Fan. Oh, wait. Oh, hello, Hashi. I thought it was Mr. Ceiling Fan.
I didn't realize. You were saying Chris, and I was like busy in Snapchat. Okay, so a couple of updates. Hannah got over her nerves, and she's going to audition for us. She's ready in the live. Nick at Night is having trouble with his Wi-Fi, so he's been in and out. So he's trying to find a better location. I told him in 5 minutes we're going to have him in. Hey, Karen Lee, so glad you're here. So glad everybody's here. I reached out to Omega Shark, have not heard from him yet, but I just reached out to him on Snapchat as well. Then Nick at Night is going to try to get on. He's just having Wi-Fi issues because of a terrible thunderstorm. So I'm excited about Hannah. I think your box works now. Why don't you exit me out of the box so we can make sure this box stays working?
All righty. You know, was it just me or was Hashi yelling? You know, he reminded me of one of those anchormans that's sitting out there, and it's very windy outside, and they're like, "We're here live breaking and investigating right here in the front of the idol show, ladies and gentlemen." And I'm just like, why is he yelling? In a hurricane, right? And so that's what it kind of sounded like. It kind of sounded like that. Alrighty. Alright, ladies and gentlemen. Third time's a charm. Miss Hannah Montana is in the box. Aww. Or not. It's like, or not. Hannah Montana, where? See, what had happened was, you know, when you, yeah, hey, we got to make excuses for the backs. See, what had happened was, she was trying to get in the box, but the box was just not filling her right now. And, you know, it's just kind of like the box said, I'm going to wait to get her in the box when it's the right time. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? That's how the box was talking. You know what I'm saying? All right. Fourth time. Ladies and gentlemen, Hannah.
Hello.
The voodoo really always works.
This really is not how I normally look, but I just figured out I was auditioning about half hour ago.
All right, sounds good. All right, well, tell us who you are, what it is that you're doing, and why do you want to become the next Unstoppable Idol?
My name's Hannah. I'm from Washington State. Yay. I've been singing since I was old enough to be able to talk. I want to be the next, really the Unstoppable Idol for me is going to be a lesson, and the critiques and all of that, I'll learn a lot from it. This is probably the biggest crowd I think I've ever performed in front of. So I'm just going to give it, I'm doing acapella today because I don't have anything prepared. So.
All right. Sounds good. You have the floor.
All right. Here we go. I've been sitting here staring at the clock on the wall, and I'll be laying here praying she won't call. It's just another call from home. You get it and be gone, and I'll be crying. And I'll be begging you, baby, begging not to leave. But I'll be left here waiting with my heart on my sleeve. Oh, for the next time we'll be here. It seems like a million years and I think I'm dying. What do I have to do to make you see that she can't love you? Why don't you stay? I'm down on my knees. I'm so tired of being lonely. Don't I give you what you need? When she begs you not to go, there's one thing you should know. I don't have to live this way. So, baby, why don't you stay? And you keep telling me, baby, there will come a time when you will leave her arms and forever be in mine. But I don't think that's the truth. and I don't like being used, and I'm tired of waiting. It's too much pain to have to bear. To love a man, you have to share. Why don't you stay? I'm down on my knees. I'm so tired of being lonely. Don't I give you what you need? When she begs you not to go, there's one thing you should know. We don't have to live this way. So baby, why don't you stay? Yeah. Whoa, whoa. There you go. My nerves are really bad right now.
Nice. Very, very nice.
Sorry about that.
I'm glad you got done with that before the dog started barking.
I oh man.
That's what happens when you're here in Kansas. I live in South Dakota. If you come to Kansas, there's a bunch of bitches everywhere.
Right?
Just say it. All right.
Well, thanks for popping.
Okay, so just real quick, now that they've stopped, how do you feel about your performance?
Actually, I feel really not very good about it because I got to put my phone on the charger. I usually feel a lot better when I'm prepared for it and have music behind it. Mm-hmm. But my grandpa's dying, so I've been taking care of him, and I wasn't going to do the audition. But I talked to Hashi today, and he goes, well, why don't you jump in as 11? I was like, you know, why not? I'll give it the shot. Next week, I will definitely be a lot better. I know that because I'll be prepared and not as nervous. But
very nice. Very nice. All right. Sounds good. All right. Well, just go ahead and wait, and we'll see what the judges have to say. Yeah, I think she did great, I guess. What do you guys think? She did amazingly. Yes. Alrighty, so, you know, people are having Wi-Fi issues, having technical issues, jumping out, jumping in. Hashi, who's next? Show the dogs. Oh, I can't. There's like 15 of them just all running around here, including mine. This is my dog sitter. My dog was looking at them earlier and was just like, so you leaving me with these mutts? I'm just saying. I was like carrying my stuff in. And so I brought her in first. And so when I went out to my car to get more stuff, she was standing at the door like, hello? Because I still had the leash on her. So she had it like, I don't know why, it was like up here on her nose or in her mouth or something. She's just like, you're forgetting me. It was the cutest thing ever. I wish I would have like recorded that. Those are those moments. Alrighty. So is any of those three here? Yes, Nick at Night is here, ladies and gentlemen. Please request the box. Yes. Brit's like, sing, motherfucker. So, all right, so this is the cops down in the South. So, y'all a singing group? Well, why won't y'all just sing something? I I have requested. Oh, did you? Maybe we'll give Famous in the Box a little bit later. Yes?
What? Oh, everybody.
What's up, Nick at Night? You know, anytime I hear your name, I must know. I must know. Did you get your name off of that sitcom from like real late at night? They yes. have those like shows.
Yes.
Is that where Nick at Night came from?
I sure did. Yeah. Doug Funny, yeah. Angry Beavers. I watched that stuff. Come on now. I know y'all didn't sit back and watch no Teletubbies all day. Y'all watch Nick and Knight, Kenan and Kel. Come on.
Correct.
Who knows?
Correct. I used to love Nick and Knight. You know, true story, you guys. True story. So when I was a kid, so I would watch Nick and Knight when I had cable. I was poor, sorry. But when I just had, you know, those channels 4, 5, 9, 41, 62, those were the only channels I had, maybe 29 when it came out. But anyways, you know, I would watch, you know, it was time to go to bed, yes? And I would watch the news, and then I would watch Roseanne at 10:30. And then I would watch the Golden Girls at 11. And then Golden Girls came on again at 11:30. And then when that next show came on, I knew it was time to go to bed. MASH. I could not stand that show. I was like, oh, nope, time to go to bed. Time to go to bed. As soon as I heard it. We're done. Nope. MASH. Nope. As soon as I saw that helicopter, because, you know, that's how it started off. As soon as I saw that helicopter, I was like, I'm done. All right. Back to you, Nick. Back to you. I need to tell that story. I had to. Okay. So tell us a little bit about yourself. What you're doing, and why did you want to become the next Unstoppable Idol?
Well, I sing all the time. On live, I sing constantly, just like thousands of others. It's just to bring kind of vibrant clauses to meet me, because you see so much negativity all over this, so much drama. No matter what you do, you just got to do something to keep it strong, keep it interesting. But it's just so silly, but keep it interesting. So yeah, I really like. It's turned into. A chill place for me, this thing. I've been on here for almost 3 years. It's been pretty chill.
Very nice. Very nice. All right. Well, you have the floor. Go ahead.
I'm going to sing this a cappella. I'm not going to put any music behind it. I'm going to slow it down a bit too. Like a lot. So I'm going to try to make it my own, but the words going to say the same. But I'm going to sing Tennessee Whiskey by Chris Stapleton. I'm going to slow it down just a bit again, so, yeah.
All right, very nice.
All right, ready? All right. I used to spend my nights out at the barroom. It was the only love I've known. But you rescued me for reading for the bottom. Brought me from being too far gone. You're as smooth as Tennessee whiskey. You're as sweet. Strawberry wine, and you're as warm as a glass of brandy. Honey, I will stay strong on your love all the time. I've looked for love in all the same old places. I found the bottom of the bottle's always dry. But when you poured out your heart, I didn't waste it. 'Cause there's nothing like your love to give me high. You're as smooth as Tennessee whiskey. You're as sweet as strawberry wine. Cause you're as warm as a glass of brandy. Cause honey, I won't stay stone on your love all the time. You're as smooth as Tennessee whiskey. You're as sweet. It's strawberry wine. You're as warm as a glass of brandy. Sorry, I won't stay stone on your love all the time. No.
Hush up, Funky. So, how do you feel about that performance?
I actually liked it. I liked it. It's just not, I feel it. It's good. So.
You should. No, you should like. You should like it, because we all liked it. We all liked it. All right. So, just go ahead and sit in the live and just wait for the judges.
See you guys.
Thank you, Nick at Night. Alrighty. So did Omega and Cosmic King make it? Oh, Ice Queen. Alrighty. Okay, so that is it. Alrighty. So now we have a new number. So is that still 10? Is that 10 that performed for us, Hashi? 9. Okay. Alright, so that is 9 contestants, ladies and gentlemen. Those are your contestants for season 8 of Unstoppable Idol. Yes! All right, so this is what we're going to do. Auditions is now closed. Yes? So this is what we're going to do. We're going to bring the judges in. Now, I know you guys are saying Turk, but Turk has to, there is a process. We have vowed that we would not just let anyone just jump in the middle of a show, especially not when we have so many contestants that we have now. So, with that being said, we're going to bring the judges back in. They are going to give their final critiques for this week. And remember, ladies and gentlemen, we're not going to have a show next week. What this means for the contestants is that they have almost 2 weeks to get ready for week 3. But since we do have 9, that means that at least 4 of you will be eliminated. So make sure, ladies and gentlemen, make sure that you bring your A game. Make sure if you're working with Hashi, if you need emotional support, reach out to Chris. reach out to Chris. You know, he might or may not be coherent, but still reach out to them. Make sure you guys go and favorite our judges. You know, Bailey's also available. Bailey is also available. Queen of Halloween is available. Jamie, the undisputed Unstoppable Idol winner of Volume 1 of Unstoppable Idol, is available. Turk just made himself available. He's like, Idol is available. Yes. All right. So with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, Hashi is in the box.
Hey, hey, I'm outside. Doing the weather out here. It's pretty clear right now. I heard some fireworks earlier. No, contestants, great job tonight. I know nerves were eating at all of you. That happens during auditions. Now it's time to shake off what you did tonight. If you want to know my comments, message me, and I will take a picture of them and send them to you. We have a lot of work to do. Because we are doing a different type of show this season, a special show next, the weather's fine, post alone. because we're doing a different type of show next week, make sure you have favorited me, because we're going to do a behind-the-curtain show next Sunday. Not only will we be having contestants in there and me working with them, but we're going to have special guests, special previous contestants will be sharing some of their insights. Marquis is going to pop in and show what he does in the behind the curtain for Idol. So it's a chance for you to see something very different. Some of you have asked, some of you wondered what happens between the weeks. You get a chance right now to find out what all of that is. So make sure you tune in. It'll be the same time next week. It'll be 7 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, 6 o'clock Central Standard Time, 5 o'clock Mountain Time, and that would be, if I get out there, yeah, 4 o'clock Pacific Standard Time. If you're not at Disney, come by and check us out. Please, contestants, keep working and thinking about songs you want to do. A few notes. One, if you're going to sing a distance from your phone and your accompaniment is closer, make sure that you balance your music. You probably need to have it a little bit lower if it's closer to your phone. Two, make sure you always remain in the box. This is only temporarily in the box. Make sure you stay in the box because we want to see those eyes. We want to see your emotions. We want to see you emoting. If you tend to move a lot, just back it up a bit so you've got some room to move around in there so you still remain in that box. But I definitely heard a lot of nerves tonight. I heard a lot of talent tonight. I'm really excited about this season. We've got 9 contestants. So tonight we're going to eliminate down to 10. So there will be no eliminations tonight. 0 eliminations. All 9 will be continuing in through the season to now week 3. So tune in next week. I'm excited. Idol, have a wonderful trip to VidCon. I look forward to hearing updates from you and Chris, whether it be drunk dialing or whatever it be. I look forward to hearing from you guys. And contestants, let's do it. Let's do it.
Thank you, Hashi. I'm a wholesome girl. I don't drink. I drink holy water. You don't drink holy water. Okay, so anyways. Alrighty. AKA wine. Correct. I call bullshit, Idol. Ain't none of y'all seen... Oh, well, wait. Never mind. Shh. Alrighty, so I want to thank each and every one of you guys for coming out to the Idol show tonight. It was super, super amazing. Tomorrow night, ladies and gentlemen, I will be in Vegas. Yes, tomorrow at this time, I will be in Vegas. It will be 6 p.m. instead of 8 p.m. or 9 p.m. for some of you guys. But I will be in Vegas tomorrow night. My flight leaves tomorrow. It's so weird because my flight leaves tomorrow at like 3 o'clock and I get to, and I land at 3:45. It's like, how are you getting to Vegas in 45 minutes? It's because of the time change. It took me like a whole week to figure that out. I was like, how am I going to get there? Damn, that plane is traveling really fast. I'm only going to get there in 45 minutes. Just saying. So, yes, ladies and gentlemen, even Idol has Bond moments. Yes? Yes. So just real quick, I spent all day Saturday, because I didn't have to work at either jobs, and I spent all day, I made my own hip pads. So if you guys are going to the roof party at VidCon, oh, wait till you see when I walk up in there. It is going to be flawless. Because I got the hip pads. Guys, just saying. And not to mention, for those of you, do you guys know Giselle? Yes? I get to spend the whole day during the day with Giselle. Giselle is going to assist me with doing my makeup. I'm very, very excited. I'm very, very excited about Thursday, the Meet Me party at VidCon. It is going to be phenomenal. Phenomenal. This Thursday. Yeah, you know, it's amazing how right now it's Sunday, okay? I'm in Kansas. I'm going to be in Vegas tomorrow. And Thursday, I'm going to be in Anaheim, California. Weird. I mean, it just seems like, whoa. Like the world is just like... All right, so but I thank all of you guys for coming in. I'm going to be taking lots of pictures. I'm going to try to stream as much as I can so you guys can be able to be there with us. Just remember, if you don't get to make it to VidCon, make sure you guys tune in to the Meet Me official. Yes, it's this is Chris's thing. This is Chris's baby. So we're gonna let him explain that. All right, guys.
What is this baby that we're talking about? Hi.
I'm so jealous. I want to be there. You guys are having a slumber party. Oh, I'm going to be there with you guys.
This is the...
Chris gets all the ladies.
This is the good life right now. Hey, everyone. My name's Chris. If I haven't met you before, this is Bailey. She's your winner from last season.
Oh,
you got Cass right here. She's hibernating in her poo blanket. I mean, like Winnie the Pooh. Not yeah, like, yeah. Here, not that you poo. She's pooing on the blanket.
I understood that. But
and then you got Sammy, the sunflower. She's right there, too. And then I'm Chris.
And we are Michigan.
Congrats to everyone that performed tonight. Bailey did an excellent job keeping diligent notes that she's not using any of them now. So I'm very sorry for that situation. But as far as the competition goes, off next week, we're all going to be at VidCon having a great time. Check into your fellow streamers' lives. There's going to be a lot of things going on, including on Wednesday, it's the Meet Me Roof Top party where there's going to be
It's Thursday night.
Wednesday night, there's a different show. That's why I got it screwed up. Wednesday night. Thank you for keeping me honest. Wednesday night is suited up. This week's guests are JXO/Jenna. Ooh. We've got John with the boat emoji. And our last guest is not Vodka or not Vodka. She doesn't have the unicorn.
Are you drunk yet? No,
I'm not drunk. I know what I'm doing. All right. And then on Thursday, it's the Meet Me Gala. There's going to be a purple carpet. You'll catch me live from Meet Me's official account. I'll be bringing people on. Did you not know that part?
No, I didn't.
We'll be bringing the streamers on, the other influencers, VIP stop badges, doing interview style. We've got pranks and all sorts of fun things planned. That's from 7 to 11 Pacific Standard Time on Thursday. All right, so that's what I had to say. I have alcohol to drink. Cheers, everybody. Oh, you bitches.
We love you.
I forgot to announce that I will be there live breaking and investigating on Suited Up with Chris. Yes? So he forgot to announce that. For
We love the idol.
If you guys see, bye-bye. If you guys see, like, Chris is trying to, you know how we can never interrupt Chris with gifts? So I'm just going to walk behind him. I'm going to be like. as he's trying to, you know, like, interview his guest, I think it would be so hilarious. So hilarious. Be like, idol childish. What? It would be funny. It would be so much fun. It'd be so much fun. So anyway, do it. Yes. All right. But no, I want to thank each and every one of you guys for coming in for Unstoppable Idol. We would not have an Unstoppable Idol if it was not for each and every one of you continuing to show your support and to come in. I just missed my plane event. God darn you bitches. I just missed my plane. That was my flight. You know, they say you're supposed to be there. You're supposed to be there 2 hours. And because I had to do this show, I just missed it. Darn. Damn spirit. Thank you so much, Sammy. Thank you so much for that. I appreciate that so much. Yes. Thank you so much, Sugar Dad Bod. Thank you so much. Speaking of Sugar Dad Bod, ladies and gentlemen, please make sure you guys go and favorite him. He is my number one gifter. Yes. Oh. This is what's going to happen when I go to VidCon. I mean, it's going to be so many storms. No, but please make sure you guys go and favorite Sugar Daddy, Sugar something, Dad Bod. I didn't forgot already. Please make sure you guys go and favorite him. Actually, he's the one that stays here in Kansas. So I'm actually at his house right now. And so it was very nice of him to allow me to bring. What? 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 Sammy, what are you doing in my life right now? Voices of darkness, empower me. Take me back to my virtual reality. Okay, I don't know where that came from, but I had to do something. it was so many of them. I just had to do like something, like if I was actually doing it. I hope somebody like screenshotted that. 2.1. Oh, am I about to hit 2.1? Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we just hit 2.1 million diamonds. Thank you, each and every one of you. Thank you. Oh, you know how the Chinese people say, oh, I love America. I love America. I'm going to say, oh, I love drunk people. I love drunk people. I'm talking about Sammy and Chris and them because they're all together. They're sending me these gifts. I love you. Dong. Dong. No, thank you guys so much. You guys are super, super awesome. Thank you. Thank you guys for tuning in. Next week, ladies and gentlemen, please make sure you guys go and favorite Hashi. He is super, super awesome. Make sure you guys favorite him because we're going to do a behind the curtains Unstoppable Idol behind the curtains with Hashi. So please make sure you guys favorite him. Hashi, if you can please say something in the live so people can just click on you and favorite you. That's a lot easier than trying to look someone up. Yep. Alrighty, so please make sure you guys go favorite Hashi. Also, oh, I got 2 minutes. Also,
please sure.
So, see, what had happened was, clean up on aisle two, okay. Oh, wow, that hurt, Idol. I know, right? So the dog came through and pulled the cord, and it just, like, yanked. How did he yank the phone all out of the holster and everything? It's God telling me. Bitch, it's time for you to hang it up. Close. Out. All right. Thank you guys for coming. So the next Idol show is going to be Sunday, July 21st. Ladies and gentlemen, for week three, we do have a special guest judge. Yes, we have a special guest judge for week three. He won his spot. And so guess what? Guess what, ladies and gentlemen? We're going to do it again. We're going to do it again in 2 weeks. During week three, we're going to have crowd participation to see who is going to be the special guest judge for week two of season nine. So week three of season eight, please make sure you bring lots of diamonds, because the number one gifter, the number one gifter of the live will be the special guest judge of season nine, week two. Yes? Of that live. Of that live. Alrighty, so with that being said, Kay is in the house. Kay, I just want to say I have to go. I have to go. My time is up. But I just want to say, Mama, I love you, and I will see you in a couple of days. Oh my God, I'm so excited. Please, guys, make sure you guys go and favorite Kay. She is one of the top badges here on the Meet Me app. Yes? And so we want to be thankful. We have to be thankful that Kay is okay, because Kay does live in California, and Holly lives in California. There's so many more. But please make sure you guys send Kay a favorite, because she had just experienced this huge earthquake, and you know, it was a big deal. It was a huge one. So with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank each and every one of you guys for coming out. We live in a wonderful, wonderful world. It does not matter what country you are from. We live in a wonderful, wonderful world. However, we do have horrible people who live in this wonderful world with us. So please make sure you guys stay safe, love yourselves, and each other. Until next time, ladies and gentlemen, I am the Bearded Goddess, the Idol, Marquise Evans, and you are watching Unstoppable Idol.